Good evening, everybody. Today we shall discuss an important subject, which is epileptiform abnormalities. Starting with the abnormalities, we can start with the slowness. Slowness may be normal, like the theta slowness during drowsiness or delta slowness during sleep. However, sometimes it can be pathological. For example, if there is generalized slowness, this may be due to encephalopathic process or due to drug effect or post-ictal state. Usually, if it is encephalopathic process, this is the slowness of the posterior dominant rhythm with disorganization of the rhythm with excessive theta activity anteriorly. Sometimes we have regional slowness. Regional slowness may be due to structural lesion or area of encephalitis or sometimes in encephalopathy. Sometimes the slowness may be focal. This is usually due to structural lesion, include focal theta activity or pleomorphic delta activity. Let us have general rules. When we have focal slowness, this usually suggests focal structural lesion underlying the scalp electrode. When we have diffuse slowness, this is usually associated with encephalopathy. When we have focal spikes or sharp wave, this may be due to structural lesion or focal onset seizure. When we have diffuse spikes or sharp waves, usually this correlates to generalized seizure. Regarding the focal slowing, focal slowing may be rhythmic, as that occurs in focal structural lesions, or it may be polymorphic. In the delta range, we call this polymorphic delta activity or PDA. This focal slowing is irregular and composed of delta activity with theta activity superimposed. PDA often appears on disorganized EEG background, but the background may be normal in some cases. PDE is most common finding in focal structural lesions such as tumors, contusion, hemorrhage, infarction, and abscess. The presence of focal spikes or sharp wave without any other disturbance on the background is seldom sign of focal parenchymal lesion, but the presence of focal spikes on top of PDE is common in this structural lesion. When we have no focal spikes or sharp waves, it may be non-specific, as it can occur in the post-ictal state or complicated migraine. If we talk about generalized slowness, we have two types of generalized slowness, either continuous diffuse slowing or intermittent slowing. Starting with the diffuse slowing, we have slowing of the posterior dominant rhythm. This means it is below 8.5 Hz in an adult awake. The posterior rhythm, when it is 8 or less, this is usually abnormal in an awake adult. The slow posterior rhythm is usually less stereotyped than the normal rhythm. Slow posterior rhythm is less reactive to eye opening than the normal rhythm. Slow posterior rhythm is usually associated with theta prominent more forward of the occipital region than the normal rhythm extending forward of the occipital region. The slow posterior rhythm is usually interpreted as being abnormal but not specific. Possible causes include toxic metabolic encephalopathy, degenerative dementia, multifocal vascular disease. Then we have a look about the intermittent rhythmic delta activity. Intermittent means we have periods of slowing in the delta rhythm, followed by normal rhythm, and it is repeated. The slow activity is usually about 2.5 hertz. In adult, it is usually frontal, and we call this frontal intermittent rhythmic delta activity, or FIRDA. In children, it is commonly to be in the occipital region. We call it occipital intermittent rhythmic delta, or OIRDA. So usually FIRDA or OIRDA lasts for several seconds, then disappears for longer period, giving the intermittent picture. The slow activity is augmented by eye closure or hyperventilation, by attenuated by stimulation or by non-REM sleep. FIRDA may appear in REM sleep and OIRDA may appear in absence epilepsy patients, but it doesn't occur during the bursts of the spike wave complexes themselves. Both FIRDA and OIRDA can be caused by midline tumors, metabolic encephalopathy, degenerative disorders, and some encephalopathies. Then we have the sharp abnormalities. The sharp abnormalities include spike, sharp wave, spike followed by a slow component, which is called spike wave complexes, sharp wave followed by a slow component, sharp and slow wave, slow spike and wave, in which the spike is part of the slow component, polyspike and wave, in which polyspikes are followed by slow component, multiple sharp waves and slow wave, and then polyspike or multiple sharp waves, we call them multiple sharp complexes when they may contain a slow component. How to differentiate between the spike and sharp wave? Spike lasts for a duration between 20 milliseconds and 70 milliseconds, but sharp wave lasts for a duration of 70 milliseconds up to 200 milliseconds. If we have potentials less than 20 milliseconds, usually this is artifactual. Regarding spikes and sharp waves, focal spikes or sharp wave is usually associated with seizure disorder of focal onset, whether this is due to structural lesions or even in the absence of structural lesions. Frontocentral discharges may be seen in patients with focal aware seizures, while temporal or frontal spikes may be seen in patients with focal unaware seizures. There are many factors that increase the likelihood or decrease the likelihood of having interictal spikes or sharp wave in our recordings. For example, these sharp waves are more common in children than adults. It is more common when epilepsy begins earlier in life. Its occurrence depends on the epilepsy syndrome. For example, it is very frequent in some epileptic syndromes like benign rolandic epilepsy. In adults, it's more common in temporal lobe epilepsy than extratemporal epilepsy. It is more common in sleep than wakefulness. It is more detected when extra electrodes are applied, like extratemporal electrodes or sphenoidal electrodes. Greater seizure frequency increases the likelihood of recording these abnormalities. They are more likely to occur after a seizure. Some anti-epileptic drugs may suppress these abnormalities, including valproate, ethosuximide, and carbamazepine. Let's see some of the patterns related to abnormalities or specific abnormalities or specific syndromes. Starting with rolandic epilepsy, we have a stereotype spike, often with triphasic appearance followed by slow wave. Independent discharges with maximum amplitude near C3 or C4, activated by sleep on top of normal background. The second one is occipital epilepsy, when there is unilateral or bilateral high amplitude occipital spikes, which are increased by light sleep and suppressed by eye opening. Absence epilepsy, we have the classical 3 Hz spike wave complexes, or very uncommonly, we may have polyspike wave that increases by hyperventilation and less well organized during sleep. We have specific patterns related to or another generalized idiopathic epilepsy, which is juvenile myoclonic epilepsy. When we see generalized polyspike wave discharges followed by slow wave, higher amplitude in the frontal region on top of normal background. For focal unaware seizures, usually we see various patterns depending on the site of origin of epileptiform abnormalities, maybe unilateral, temporal, or frontal spikes, focal slowness, or no discharge recording from surface electrode. Focal aware midline spikes with prominent negative phase or biphasic in most patients. Occasional patient may have positive prominence on surface EEG. These patterns correlate with simple motor seizures. With the generalized tonic-clonic seizures, we have generalized polyspikes that often but not invariably has a slow component. Ictal activity is usually high frequency spike without obvious slow component. Lennox-Gastaut syndrome, we have slow spike wave complexes, usually 2.5 Hz or less, slow background in many patients, increasing disorganization during sleep. If we look to non-epileptic phenomena such as subacute sclerosing panencephalitis, we have periodic high amplitude bursts of sharp wave, often with an irregular delta wave superimposed, synchronous between the hemispheres. Duration is usually half to 2 seconds, many seconds to a minute or more in between the bursts. While in Jacob-Crutz field, we have periodic complexes with a frequency of half to 2 Hz per second, with maximum amplitude anteriorly, with abnormal background, with low voltage slowing. Periodic complexes disappear during sleep. Anoxic encephalopathy, we have from normal to isoelectric depending on the severity, common patterns including burst suppression or periodic pattern that resembles Jacob-Crutz field. Alpha coma is a diffuse, non-reactive alpha activity with frontocentral dominance. These later indicate poor prognosis. Herpes simplex encephalitis, generalized slowness with frontotemporal predominance, periodic complex of sharp wave or sharply contoured slow waves, which appear irregularly, high amplitude discharges with a frequency of 0.2 to 1 per second, usually in the frontotemporal region. At the end, I thank you very much for your attention and wish you good luck.